Oral questions by members.
Leader of the Official Opposition.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. On October 5th, shortly 2015, shortly after Alex Gervais jumped from a window in an Abbotsford hotel room that he had been consigned to, the Premier said she wasn't interested in an independent review of his death. Having now read the report by the representative of Children and Youth, I can understand why the Premier wanted to keep this under wraps. The report is an indictment on the government. It's an indictment on the children in care in this province, and it's absolutely unacceptable. But the Premier's response and the Minister's response has been predictable. As with the death of Paige Gauthier, as with the death of Nick Lang, as with the death of Isabel Weens, as with the death of Carly Fraser, the response from the government is uniform. We will do better. Yet after each death, no action is taken. Yesterday, the Liberals laid out, the government laid out their plan for the year ahead and made no reference whatsoever to children in care. My question through you, Honourable Speaker, to the Premier is, after all of these failures, year after year after year, why should anyone who's concerned about vulnerable children believe a word this government says?
Madam Premier.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The death of Alex Gervais is a tragedy, and it's a loss for everyone who loved him. It's a loss for all of us that care about vulnerable children, which is everybody in British Columbia, everybody in this house. And everyone knows that looking after vulnerable people, especially vulnerable children, is the most important work that government can do, that families can do. It's also the most difficult work that families and government can do. We have a duty to do that work well. We have a duty to make sure that children are protected when they are vulnerable. That didn't happen in the case of Alex Gervais. We, though, also have a duty now to learn from what went wrong in the case of Alex Gervais and make sure that we correct the mistakes that were made. The ministry has already taken immediate steps, and longer-term steps are also underway in response to what happened to Alex. Again, it's a terrible tragedy, and our duty is to respond in the face of those tragedies, to make sure to do everything that we can to learn from them and to ensure to the extent that we can that they don't happen again.
Leader of the Official Opposition on a supplemental.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. And again, Paige, Nick, Isabella, Carly, Alex, these are teachable moments. One would think that a government would harness all of its resources, everyone working together to find solutions, not just to continue to deflect when another child dies in the care of this government. They're there for the wealthy and the well-connected, Honourable Speaker. They're not there for the vulnerable. Just before Alex's death, he reached out. On five different occasions, he reached out to social workers, he reached out to caregivers, and he was told in the report that the ministry had given this young boy's life, quote, profound instability and neglect. Five separate occasions, professionals called out to this government for mental health assistance for Alex Gervais, and they were denied. On five occasions, the government was asked to help this young boy, and they didn't. Can the Premier, Honourable Speaker, through you, tell the people of British Columbia when she will start to care about the vulnerable in this province and let the wealthy and the well-connected take care of themselves?
Madam Premier.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. We have what happened to Alex Gervais was a tragedy, and our responsibility and our duty to Alex, everyone who loved him, and all of the vulnerable children in British Columbia who are in government's care and who aren't, is to learn from it and to make sure that those lessons find their way into the practice of the incredibly hardworking social workers who are out there on the front lines every day doing the work of angels, the kind of work that most of us might not even have the courage to do. It's difficult work, it's hard work, but it is the most important work that we do. The ministry had a budget increase of over $72 million last year. And that money has gone into supporting more social workers to make sure that we have more frontline staff. It's gone into supporting more adoptions, supporting families so that we can try and keep children out of care. In addition to that, the ministry has accepted all 700 recommendations from the representative and will be acting on all of those, some specifically related to this case. For example, allocating $2.7 million to Indigenous organizations to help them develop culturally specific plans, mandating 100% compliance with the requirement to have a plan of care for all children and youth in government care, implementing continuous monitoring. A list of actions that the ministry has undertaken in response to the report to take effect immediately, because young people like Alex don't have someone to depend on in many cases. That's why they find their way into government care. And government needs to be there to support them and make sure that they are cared for. This minister cares about that. Our government is investing in that. It is hard work, it is difficult work, but it is important that every year we strive to make sure that we are doing it as well as we possibly can.
Leader of the Official Opposition.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. With the greatest of respect, these children do have someone they can depend on. It's supposed to be the British Columbia government. It's supposed to be the responsibility of the Minister of Children and Family Development. That's who should be caring for these kids. We've heard it time and time and time again. We accept all the recommendations, but we don't accept responsibility. If this is the most important thing government can do, Honourable Speaker, why not one mention, in a speech from the throne prior to an election campaign? Why was this, again, swept under the rug? More deflection, more distraction, zero accountability. In his last days, Honourable Speaker, alone in a hotel room, Alex reached out by text to his former caregiver, his former social worker, and the caregiver that was supposed to be with him, appealing for help, and he went ignored. Honourable Speaker, I'm fearful that the government will again deflect, again ignore, and again pretend that they give a darn about the vulnerable children of British Columbia. Through you to the Premier, why in the world would anybody, after Paige, after Nick, after Isabella, after Carly, and now after Alex Gervais, believe a word they say?
Madam Premier.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. You know, for the children who depend on the government, they, as I said, they have no one often else in their lives to look to. And so that's why it is so important that government be there for them. And part of that is making sure that we respond to the recommendations that we see from the rep, which the ministry is doing. But it's also making sure that the ministry has the resources that it needs to be able to look after children to the standard that we need to, that they depend on us to provide. So $72 million last year, the member will see in the coming budget that there will be more resources that go to the Ministry of Children and Families, more resources that we can invest in support programs, that we can invest in children who are leaving care and trying to find their way out of care on a stable footing, resources that we can invest in social workers, in life skills programs, in the various programs, all of which underpin our ability to be able to meet our responsibility to look after vulnerable young people. Alex Gervais' case is an example of one where many, many things went wrong. We need to learn from that. We are acting on the recommendations already. We are going to continue to implement new policies within the ministry, and we are going to continue to devote more resources from government to make sure that we support social workers and the work that they do in the programs and enriching the programs that young people depend on in our system so that we can learn from things, from tragic events like the one that we saw with Alex Gervais.